In the latest Home Assistant release, Media Browser was renamed to just Media. But that is not the only new thing in the new Home Assistant Media section. It is just the opposite. The media is now full of features like casting from the web browser, integration support of Plex, VLC, LibreELEC, Apple TV, Spotify and more. In this video, I'm going to show you these Home Assistant media integrations, but first, I will show you the integrated browser player and how to upload media files so the player can see them and play them. The first method for transferring files that I want to show you is using File Editor. I'll go to Configuration, Add-ons, Backups and Supervisor, Add-on Store, and I'll search for File Editor. I'll click on it and then I'll hit Install. I will wait for the installation to finish. Okay, File Editor is installed. I'll go to Configuration first. And the key moment here is to disable this. Enforced base path should be set to false. That way I can freely browse any folders inside my Home Assistant. I'll go back to Info tab and I'll hit Start. I'll click on the Open Web UI and this is File Editor. I'll click on this folder icon and I'm currently in config folder, but I want the media one. Here it is, media folder, and inside this folder I can upload a file, for example this song. I have to wait a bit. Upload is successful and the file is in my media folder. And now if I go to the media section, I can see my file there and I can play it. Okay, it is working.
File Editor add-on is good to upload single, not very big file. But if you wish to upload many songs or movies, big folders and so on, it is better to use the Home Assistant Samba add-on. This is how you can do that.
I'll go again to Configuration, Add-ons, Add-on Store, and I'll search for Samba. Here it is, Samba Share, Install. Samba Shared is installed. I'll go to Configuration tab again and I'll add a password here. My username is Home Assistant and I'll make my password Home Assistant as well. And I'll save the configuration. Then I'll go back to Info tab and I'll click Start. The Samba Share is now started and I can connect to the network shares using Finder for macOS or Windows Explorer if you're using Windows. Like that. This is my Home Assistant IP. I'll hit connect. Connect again. And now I have to type my username, which is Home Assistant, and the password that I set during the configuration. In my case, it is again Home Assistant. I recommend to choose better password here, but I'm using this only for tests. Select the volumes you want to mount, and I want the media volume. Okay, as you can see, my song is already there, and in this folder I can copy folders and bigger files as usual. For example, this MP4 file, which is around 10 megabytes, I can copy it right here. And it happens almost instantly. Now, if I go back to the media section of Home Assistant, I can see my MP4 file here and I can play it. Great, it is working.
Home Assistant VLC add-on allows you to use your local device as media player if you attach some USB speakers on it. That works perfect if you have your Home Assistant installed on a Raspberry Pi, Android, or you're using Home Assistant Blue or yellow. Let's see what we have in Home Assistant media section after VLC add-on installation and configuration.
For the VLC add-on, I'll go once again to Configuration, Add-ons, Backups and Supervisor, Add-on Store, And I'll search for VLC. Here it is. Install. The VLC add-on is installed. No configuration is needed, so I'll just hit start. And I will go to configuration, devices and services, add integration. I'll search for VLC. Here it is. Actually, it is already auto-discovered. You can click here on this card as well. But anyways, I'll click on this. Do you want to connect to add-on VLC? Yes. Finish. I'm ready with the VLC installation and configuration. And now if I go to media section, browser, I'll move this a bit. I can see that I have also a VLC telnet option here that I can select. And this is my only file suitable for playing in my media folder. And I can click on play button. And it is start playing from my USB speakers. If you have Plex Media Server installed, you can add it to Home Assistant. Plex Media Server is also available as Home Assistant add-on in the Home Assistant add-on store. And I have a dedicated video about that. No matter where exactly Plex Media Server is installed, you can add it in your Home Assistant. If you do that, it will be also visible in the Home Assistant media section. Let's see this! I already installed the Plex Media Server add-on, which is installed as usual from the Home Assistant add-on store. Then I configure it by clicking on configuration. I get the claim code and I paste it here. I enabled web tools and from info tab I start the Plex Media Server add-on. These steps are well described in my Home Assistant Plex Media Server video that I'm going to share with you right now, somewhere on the screen. And because I'm ready with all of these steps, I'll go to configuration, devices and services, add integration. And I'll search for Plex. Here it is, Plex Media Server. I have two options here, obtain a new token from Plex TV and configure Plex server manually. I'll choose the first one. I'll click submit. I have to sign in my Plex account. Now I have to wait for this loading to finish. Success, finish, and I have Plex Media Server added in my Home Assistant. If I go to media section now, and then on this button, I can see Plex, Plex Web Safari as option here. And if I click on it, I can see my Plex Media Library. I can browse the folders. I can start playing something. And if I open my Plex Media Server web interface, I can go to music, for example, and I can start this song. If I go back, you can see that the player here is synchronized and I can pause it. LibreELEC integration is also visible in Home Assistant media section. Check this video of mine if you wish to see all of the details about LibreELEC and Home Assistant. Now, I will quickly add this and then I'll check the media section. And the next thing that I want to show you is LibreELEC. I'll go again to configuration, devices and services, add integration, and I'll search for this integration. I'll select it. I'll type my LibreELEC IP and I'll click submit. Success, finish. And now I have this integration as well. If I go to media, I can select it from here. And again, I can browse my library. I can start and stop different media from my library. And everything is working great. If you want to know more about this integration, this Home Assistant LibreELEC integration, check my video.
I'm showing all of the details how to install one.
Apple TV is usually auto-discovered by Home Assistant and can be easily added as integration. If you do that, Apple TV will be also visible in the Home Assistant media section automatically. Let's see that in action.
As usual, I'll go to Configuration, Devices and Services. Here is my Apple TV. I just have to click Configure because it is auto-discovered by Home Assistant. To complete the process, you may have to enter multiple PIN codes. Okay, submit. Now the PIN code is displayed on my Apple TV and I have to check it and enter it right here. Give me a sec. The code is 1079. Submit. Success. Finish. And I have an Apple TV. Where it is? Here it is. Great. If I go to media, I can see my living room, which is the name of my Apple TV. If I select it, I can see my installed application inside my Apple TV, which is pretty cool. If I click on YouTube, nothing happens. VLC, I guess it is not clickable, but if I go now and start a YouTube app on my Apple TV, let's see what will happen. Yes, I started a YouTube clip and I can control it from here, which is great. Interestingly enough, when I click on this YouTube folder right here, the YouTube was started on my Apple TV. So I guess it is kind of possible to control your Apple TV from here.
I have to admit that I failed to add Spotify in Home Assistant Media for some reason. I successfully added the Spotify integration, but still, Spotify is not visible in my media section of Home Assistant. I will show you what I did, and if you know what's the reason, let me know in the comments.
The next thing that I want to show you is Spotify. It is auto-discovered again. If it is not, you can add it from here. And currently, there are two possible methods to add Spotify in Home Assistant. Using the Home Assistant Cloud or using the configuration.yaml. If I try the Home Assistant Cloud method, even though I activated my Nabu Casa, here is what is happening. This is done, but this dialog right here is trying to do something for around 15 minutes and then it fails. So it is not working for me for some reason. Maybe it will work for you. I don't know. Let me know in the comments. So I tried the other method, the manual one, with the configuration.yaml. Here is my configuration.yaml. I'll leave this spinning and I'll open a new Home Assistant window like that. I'll start my file editor. Open web UI. And I'll open my configuration.yaml file. This is my Spotify section. I added my client ID and my client secret, which is stored in my secrets.yaml file. And if I try again, while this is still spinning, oh, it is finished now. It says aborted, which is not very useful. I'll try to add Spotify in Home Assistant using the manual method. And again, I'll click Add Integration. I'll search for Spotify. In order to see this dialog right here, you first have to enter the Spotify section in your configuration.yaml exactly as I did and exactly as I showed you before. So I'll select this and I'll click Submit. And almost instantly the success dialog is shown and I just have to click Finish. And this is my Spotify integration. Everything seems good here. I have one service, I have one entity, I can add this as card on my Lovelace. But if I go to media section, the Home Assistant media section, and if I click on the button right here, I'll move this a bit, I see nothing. I see all of my previous integrations, but Spotify is missing. I try to restart, I try to reload the integration,
I tried almost anything that I can think of, but Spotify is not displayed here. I don't know what is the reason, maybe you can tell me in the comments.
Do you like to bookmark some stuff in your browser? If yes, this next section is for you.
I want to show you one more thing. Every integration have different URL here in the Home Assistant media section. For example, my Apple TV have this URL. If I change this to VLC Telnet, the URL is different. Same is valid for all others. Plex media, as you can see here. This can be very useful, as you can bookmark this URL and go straight to the integration that you want.
If you have difficulties to understand some of the abbreviations and acronyms here, do not worry, as I have a smart home glossary just for you. Go to my website, KPeyanski.com/glossary, and download it for free. I'm Kirill, and I'm done speaking. Bye!